Hello guys, welcome to Aero Robotics. So in the today's video, I'm going to make this drone, and it's not a simple drone, it's a medicine supplier drone. And it's a quadcopter H mode configuration for the first time on my YouTube channel. So let's start the video. So first we will talk about the electronics which I will use in this drone. Now without wasting any time, let's start the making process. To make this drone, I am using arms of my previous retired VTOL, and the benefit of this arm is that the motors are pre-installed, so that's why I don't need to install motors. With these two arms, I will also decide to add two more arms at the center to attain the H mode configuration. And one more thing, ESCs are also installed, and the power pins of each ESC is connected to this single XT90 connector, and this connector will be attached to the power module to get direct power from the battery. And each ESC have its own wire, and I will also add numbering on these wires according to this Pixoc motor layout for the H mode. And the motors are also installed according to this clockwise anti-clockwise chart. So now I have to install these wooden sticks. So after installing it, our frame is complete, and I have also added bolts to give it extra strength, and I attach this with the help of glue. After that, I will install the central structure, and it's made up of homemade glass fiber. Now our structure is complete, and it's time to install electronics. And before installing electronics, I am painting this with black paint, and after painting, this is the final product. Now it's time to install the electronics. So let's install our flight controller, and then we will install our GPS module and other components. So all the electronics are installed and wiring is also complete. So now one thing is left, which is our delivery servo, and I will make a wooden structure for this servo. So let's install this on the bottom of our drone, and after installing this, this is the result. And this wooden structure also works as our battery holder. Our servo pin goes to aux out 1. Now everything is almost complete. Now it's time to program this drone. And programming is very simple, as we program a normal quadcopter drone. This programming is very simple. So that's why I don't want to waste time. You can see the programming video from the top. The thing in the programming which is different for this drone is that I have also introduced a servo. So that's why I need to set the servo in programming. So this is a little bit different thing. So that's why I will show you how to set the servo to your RC channel. So let's start this. In the Autopilot mission planner software, after connecting our drone, we need to go to setup. And in the servo section, now there are many servos, and I have installed my servo to servo 9. In the flight controller, it's main out 1. I will also set how to operate this servo, which is with the help of channel number 6 of my RC transmitter. So now this servo is connected to my RC channel number 6, which is a switch. And one more thing, I'm showing you this servo tutorial on a VTOL quad plane, so these settings are not for drone, so please ignore it. Now after programming and after setting up the servo, our drone is complete. Now let's fly this drone. And one more thing is that I have tilt my flight controller about 90 degree because this configuration is called H mode configuration, but in reality this look like I, so that's why I tilt my flight controller a little bit. So now this is I mode. No, it's H mode, but it's look like I. Now let's fly this drone. So as you can see, our drone fly very well, and after that I make it presentable by covering all the wires, and I've also introduced cockpit like structure on my flight controllers and all the other electronics. Now the quadcopter is flying in fully autonomous mode, and it's a very small mission, like plane go high and then forward, reverse and again land. Now it's time for the delivery. Let's see. So the delivery feature also work very well, and the drone is flying in very stable way, like forward, backward. It's very responsive. So that's the today's video, and if you have any type of question, you can ask me in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more interesting projects like this.